This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Have you ever wanted to play a big role in a Hollywood film? Well, I've got the secret on how you can get in and party with the celebrities, even films that are already out. Because we're gonna do some editing. Not sure if you can party with the celebrities afterwards, but you sure can edit yourself in that party. Last week, or was 2 weeks ago, I don't know, some time ago, we published a video about how to create the black veins on Billy from Stranger Things season 3. But for the intro, I decided to have some fun and made this fun skit where I removed the actual Billy from the scene and placed myself in there. And we actually had no time at all to make this. Everyone was saying here, Jory, stop spending your time in this. But anyways, that had to go super fast and 100 things went wrong. Like you can see here, the background glitching and all. But for the skit, we didn't really care so much for those glitches. Surprisingly, you guys really enjoyed that intro and were wondering how I did it. Well, I'd love to show you guys. It all starts with filming yourself. You want to recreate the lighting for starters, and if you're unsure on how to do that, then start off with the easiest, which is picking an outdoor scene. This means that you only need to pay attention to the position of the sun, so that's quite easy. If you're swapping yourself with someone walking, you're gonna have to mimic that walk as well. And don't just stand still and walk on the spot, as you'll definitely notice that. You could use a treadmill, which is definitely gonna work and make it yourself easier. But if you don't have that, you'll have to walk and have two guys walk with you holding a green screen. And since the original scene was shot from a Steadicam, we could also just shoot ours from a gimbal. Since it's pretty fluent and we're working on slow motion, it will match pretty well. If your scene is handheld, then it's gonna be trickier. You're gonna have to do a 3D camera tracking. And for that, I'm gonna link to another video in the description below, as we already covered that multiple times. So that's the shot. Now let's see in After Effects how we can remove Billy. Start off by drawing a mask around the object that you want to remove. And you might need to animate this mask as well so that it keeps covering your subject. Also, make sure to invert your mask if you want to get rid of it. And finally, also feather the mask a little bit more, that way you'll get better results. Now, from the window menu, locate the Content Aware Fill. From this window, make sure that object is selected from the fill method. This means that you want to remove an object. Now, there are two ways to start removing Billy. The way that I've done it was just clicking on Generate Fill Layer. After Effects will then make its calculations and paint away Billy frame by frame into a new PNG sequence. And this is really it, there's nothing more to it. The only problem is that you've cut out a pretty large chunk for the video and you're letting the entire automatic system take care for the removal. So your background is gonna glitch tremendously. A little fix that I did was adding Gaussian blur on the clip to cover up those mistakes, but you can only blur it for a little bit, so it's not really a solution. Now, this is how I did it. If you've got more time than me, then before you click on Generate Fill Layer, you first click on Create Reference Frame. Adobe Photoshop will pop open with the first frame of your clip in it. You can then go ahead and paint the background yourself now. Now, I have no patience whatsoever for this, and I'm sure it won't fix the issue, as there are like hundreds of people walking around in the background, so I would never do this myself, personally. I know that Janik can probably do this, he's got more patience than me, but he's on vacation right now, so that's not really gonna help. So, assuming that we've painted back everything in Photoshop, you can then click on Generate Fill Layer, and you should get a better result now. So finally, you place yourself in the shot, mask around your green screen and pull the key using key lights, and then comes the color correction. Now, this is gonna be different for every scene, so I can't really give you a straightforward answer. The scene looks very warm, that is what I paid attention to, so I used Lumetri to pull a lot of orange into the midtones. A lot of orange, cause I'm pretty white. They even saw me shooting this intro from the International Space Station. Now, to neutralize the shadows, which are also orange now, I added the opposite blue. And this is the base. Now, furthermore, I look at the contrast and the exposure levels and just try to match them side by side. Now, I actually have a tutorial planned very soon about matching shots and creating looks and so on. So if you're interested, make sure to subscribe. And now, let's check out the master shots. The very first one where I came through the door, but first, a big shout out to our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. Now, it's an online library that I can highly recommend to any creative person, as there's always something that can help with your creative work. From high-quality stock clips to templates and presets, overlays, effects, and so much more, you can download unlimited video assets without additional fees if you become a premium member. You can join me as well on Storyblocks by clicking the first link in the description below. And now back to the clip where Billy walks through the door. Here I didn't have to remove much from the shot, only a tiny part where Billy came in front of the wall. The hardest part was getting me into that shot. So we took an actual wall outside which had a door in it, and I would simply walk through that door, paying much attention to the same timing. As for the lighting behind the door, that was just a black curtain, so that I would come out from a dark room. I could have placed a green screen in there, but that meant that I needed to remove Billy entirely, and the lighting would be an issue, since I needed to come out from a dark room. And pulling a key from a low light scene is gonna be super hard, so I believe that we had the perfect solution there. In After Effects, I enabled timer mapping for the layer, and with its opacity set to 50, I saw the background clip. Going frame by frame forward, I changed the time value to synchronize the speed of the door with the one from the real shot. Then I drew a mask around the casket of the door and animated where the door would open. We also shot this from a tripod, because my door needed to stick perfectly into the existing door. So I did a simple motion tracking for the position, scale, and rotation on some dirt marks that I found in the real shot. Now, where I came out of the door in front of the brick wall, well, that was one of the darkest moments in my life, because I had to mask myself out frame by frame. And I don't have the patience for it, guys. I just really don't. And before you say rotoscope, well, that tool has never worked for me, so be my guest.
She's coming down. And showtime.
Hey you! I see that you don't have a Storyblocks subscription yet. Do you want to miss out on the most amazing deal for filmmakers? I don't think so. Now click the link below, kiddo.
Afternoon, Jordy.
I put a link in the description below, Mrs. Wheeler.
Thank you.
And that's it, guys. That is how I placed myself in Stranger Things. But most importantly, how the content-aware fill works, which is the educational value from this video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And as always, stay creative.
Hey, you! I see that you don't have a Storyblocks subscription yet. You're missing out on a great deal.
Man, do you want to miss out on
it? I see that you're not downloading unlimited video assets from Storyblocks yet.
I'm Billy. Dark hair, Billy.